And welcome back, folks. Welcome back to the Ludum Dare Game Marathon. This marathon is nearing the end, as is the Ludum Dare Game Competition. But we've still 2 days, and during these 2 days we want to play a few more games. One of them is Pod 2000, which had some rather interesting visuals that very much looked like had the Fallout aesthetic, or at least the sort of the Pip-Boy aesthetic from Fallout 3 and Fallout 4. So let us play the game without any further ado. Welcome again, Agent XD6000001. You've got a new match type inbox. From Bernard McLinden. No surprise, investors are pushing us for exoplanet LD38. You know the drill. Land the rover on the surface, deploy solar arrays, settle the communication network, install the ore extractor and refinery. Be quick, be efficient, don't lose your time around this small rock. And don't listen to the rover, the new firmware made it a little poetic, you'll see. P.S. In case you forget it, you'll have to undock your rover. Okay. Okay, where am I? That's a good question. We are docked in the pod. Let me just adjust the microphone a little bit. Okay, this should be now a little easier to type. Okay, let us read this letter again because I didn't pay attention at all. Okay, land the rover on the surface. Deploy solar arrays. Let us just undock. Depressuring process. Ooh. Everything all right. Yes. Hello, operator. I'm VJNet42, your recon rover. I'm finally landed on this small planet. Feel free to send instructions. I'm freezing here, but I feel attracted to this place. Don't ask me why. Okay. We should probably deploy the solar. Okay. Maybe you want to deploy the solar panels somewhere else. Maybe the desert is a good place. Hot wind and sand aren't good mix for my core processes, but the view of the dunes, I wish you were with me to see this. Okay, maybe we'll want to send you to the Rocky Mountains. Maybe the tundra. I will call it tundra. Nothing but infinite landscape where fragile planets and bush grow despite the continuous polar cold wind. Can we build the solar panel here? Okay, oops. And I'm, yeah. Maybe in the grasslands. What a beautiful place. The blue sky, the shiny sun, the soft wind. It is a call for meditation. 0001 001 001 001 001. Okay, can rebuild the energy panel? No, we can't. Okay, maybe on the seashore. Aha! Energy wind turbines installed successfully. Okay, the communication module, guess we can't install here. Nope. Maybe, okay. Maybe here. Sorry. Oops. Aha. I had some problems during the installation. I patched it. I really hope it will hold. Would be a shame. Call it wasteland. Can't pass that sentence. Anyway. So it remains to communication module and extractor module. Guess maybe I would assume that we deploy the extractor module in the Rocky Mountains. It is hard for my wheels to proceed in this cliff, but I want to see what it feels like to be on top of the world. Rebuild the communication. Well, the communication should be buildable here. Aha, yeah. Okay, now the extractor, maybe the tundra. Okay. And that was it, I guess. Subject LD-39 ASAP from Bernard McGlynn. Well received the confirmation of station health check. Everything is okay. We started the extraction. Your job is done here. By the way, engineers messed up again. They didn't manage to remotely update your rover's firmware. It seems the patch is not applicable. Anyway, let it there. What? Let it stay there, I guess. Maybe this actually sounds like a mistake a German speaker would make. Let it there. Anyway, you'll receive a new rover on LD-39. Your new mission starts now. What are you doing? Don't let me alone. You finished pod 2000, or did you? I guess we did. Rather short. The content that is there, I think, is rather it's coherent and polished and enjoyable. But I sort of would like to continue to play this game. I really enjoyed that. Okay, and I hope you enjoyed this video, short as it probably will be, and I hope to see you in the next one. So until next time, folks, until then.